Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how you can quickly and easily hide the icons on your desktop with the simple app you can create in Automator. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a terrific group of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So if you have a cluttered desktop with a bunch of stuff on there, you may want to occasionally hide it, maybe to give a presentation or just to get stuff out of the way so you can concentrate on what you're doing. Now you can do that using a terminal command. I'm going to show you how. But then we're going to use that terminal command to build a simple app in Automator that will allow you to toggle the desktop on and off. So let's start off by going to the terminal. There's a terminal command you can use to hide the desktop icons. And that is use defaults right, which is what you use to change a system preference, one that isn't in the system preferences app. And we have to identify the group of system preferences. In this case, it's com.apple.finder. In other words, system preferences that have to do with the finder. And the specific preference is create desktop. And this is what will create the desktop, including the icons, when the finder runs. And we will set it to false. Now when we run it, nothing's going to happen at first because all we've done is change the preference. But if we restart the finder, and you can do that with kill all, one word, finder, then it will relaunch the finder, and this time we won't have icons on the desktop. So there's nothing there. Not only that, but if you click on the desktop background, nothing happens. It doesn't switch to the finder because the desktop is no longer part of the finder. So there are two advantages to actually having this turned off. To turn it back on, we use the same command again. I'm going to use up arrow here in terminal to go back there, but replace false with true. And then run kill all finder again, and we'll get our icons back. So that's how you can do it in the terminal. But you don't want to have to type this every time you want to hide these. You want it to be quick and easy. So we're going to write a Automator script, something that uses these same commands. So let's run Automator. And we'll select application as the type here. And then we're going to search here for shell because we want to use run shell script. So in other words, we can do exactly what we did before. I'm going to change the shell type to Z shell since that's going to be the default in Catalina anyway. But the same thing will work with the bash shell too. So we can add the same thing in here. So when I run this, it will turn off the desktop. And if I change false to true, we can get the desktop back by running it again. Now what would be nice is if we could toggle them. And we can because we can use an if statement inside of the shell. So we can do if, and I'm going to do dollar sign and then parentheses and then a semicolon. And in here is where we want to put the condition. We can do the same thing we've got here, but instead of writing to the preferences, we can read from them. So I'm going to copy and paste this here and change write to read. So it's going to read the value of create desktop. Then we could use then, and if this value is true, then what we're going to do is set it to false. Else, and we'll set it to true. So in other words, do the opposite. And you end an if then with the opposite of if. And then we kill all finder regardless of whether we're setting it to false or true. So now it's going to toggle. Let's test it out. We run it. We can see it turns off the desktop. If we run it again, it'll toggle it back on and turn the desktop back on. Now we can save this and it becomes an application. So we could save it anywhere we want. I could just put it in a folder there in my home folder. We'll call it toggle desktop and we'll save it there. And now I can quit Automator. I can bring up the finder here and go to that application. I could stick it in my applications folder too. That's probably a better place for it, or maybe even inside utilities and applications. And if I run it here, it will do the same thing. And you can see it's restarting the finder. I'm going to get the finder back. And I want you to notice that you can still get to your desktop files in the finder. The folder is still there. The file is still there. It's just not visible in a second location, which is on the desktop. So if I toggle it again, it will go back on. and I'll get the icons back. Now what I could do is I could take that app and drag it into the dock for even easier access. So I'll stick it in the dock there and I can get rid of it there, and now I can just double click it in the dock to run it and it will turn them off. Double click it again and it will turn the desktop back on.
You can also make it a service or quick action in Automator, and then it's available in the services menu. You can make it a dictation command. There's all sorts of things that you could do to make the Automator action readily accessible.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.